Hello students, in last lecture we have seen liquid disinfectants which are cool tar disinfectants which includes phenol, cresol, ezol, lysol and chlorhexidine, dettol, etc. So we are just quickly revising it a bit. So cool tar disinfectants includes phenol which is used as a standard for comparing the germicidal activity of disinfectants, which is brown in color and it is in crystal forms. It has caustic action and we have seen all these things. It's in presence of organic matter, it doesn't interfere with its action. So that is the good quality of phenol. But due to its injurious property for the skin, it is not used as an antiseptic. Then crude phenol, that is phenyl, it is active disinfectant and it is used for antiseptic purpose also. Then we have seen the cresol, which is also excellent coal tar disinfectant, more powerful and not toxic to tissues. Cresol is another disinfectant, coal tar disinfectant, which is more powerful than phenol, which is non-toxic tissues. It is oily liquid, turns white on dilution with water, and it has five to 10% strength. It is used to disinfect feces and urine also. Rather than phenol, it doesn't lose its germicidal activity in presence of soap. Phenol loses its germicidal activity in presence of soap. So cresol is used, actually it becomes more powerful when it is saponified. So it is used as a Lysol, Ezol and Silene are popular examples of cresol, saponified cresol, which are popular disinfectants in hospitals. Lysol is 5 to 10 times more powerful than phenol, used in for disinfecting hands, clothes, excreta and hospital equipments. Then Ezol and Silene, they both have special properties. Ezol is more active against colitaphyd group of organisms, and Silene, which is 17 times more powerful than phenol, is mainly used to disinfect drains and latrines. Then hexachlorophane is the disinfectant which is having combination of phenol and chlorine, that is chlorinated phenol. It is efficient antiseptic for skin and it is used as deodorizer. Then our most popular, Dettol, which contains the chloroxylenol. So Dettol is a coal tar disinfectant. So you should know that Dettol, in which category Dettol comes, it comes under coal tar disinfectants. It is 70 times more powerful germicidal than phenol. It is more powerful than phenol, but it loses its activity, germicidal activity, in presence of organic matter. And it has not that much activity against gram-negative bacteria. That is also a drawback of Dettol. And then it is non-corrosive and non-irritating, so used in surgical antiseptics for wounds. Then next one is chlorhexidine, that is Hibitane. It is also a coal tar disinfectant, which is non-irritating antiseptic, that is destroys bacteria by disrupting cell membranes. It is also used as general skin antiseptic, used in creams and lotion, and also recommended for burns. It is also recommended for mouthwash also. Then we have seen up to this. Now, quaternary ammonium compounds. So, which are quaternary ammonium compounds? So, especially citramide, Savlon and Zephyrin. So, Savlon is one of the popular antiseptics. You might be knowing all. Then Dettol, we have seen Dettol and this is Savlon. So, the major difference between Dettol and Savlon is Dettol is a coal tar disinfectant and Savlon is quaternary ammonium compound. Then first quaternary ammonium compound is cetrimide. Cetrimide is also known as Cetavlon. It is also marketed as in the name of Cetavlon. It has a soapy feel. It is efficient surface cleansing cum disinfectant. Means it contains soap that cleanses the surface, cleans dirt, grease, tar and blood of roadside wounds. So it is useful in that scenario. It is used in 1% strength and popularly in the management of wounds, and also used for disinfection of surgical instruments and gloves also. So cetaolone, it is a soapy quaternary ammonium compound. Then cevlon is a combination of cetaolone and chlorhexidine. So cevlon is combination of both quaternary ammonium compound and coal tar disinfectants. It contains cetaolone, that is cetrimide, and the earlier we have seen chlorhexidine. Chlorhexidine is the last compound of coal tar disinfectant group. So cevlon is a mixture of coal tar and quaternary ammonium compound, whereas Dettol is only a coal tar disinfectant. So in that case we can say that cevlon is more stronger, more powerful than Dettol. So cevlon is a combination of cetaolone and chlorhexidine, that is ibuprofen, and cevlon is popular for cleaning, disinfecting and sanitizing agent. It is also used for surgical wound cleaning, and 1:6% spirit and cevlon, this mixture is the best disinfectant for clinical thermometers and plastic appliances. Many a times you have seen that thermometer is put inside a orange colored bottle, that is nothing but the cevlon, which is mixture with spirit. So cevlon with spirit, it is a very good disinfectant. Then zephyrin is also a quaternary ammonium compound used as a preoperative skin disinfectant for wounds. And it is all-purpose disinfectant and antiseptic. Then third group, first group is we have seen coal tar disinfectants, second group quaternary ammonium compound, and this is third one. It is not a group, but it is a special agent. It is iodine. Let's have a look behind. Yes, liquid disinfectants categories contains coal tar disinfectant, quaternary ammonium compound and iodine, hydrogen peroxide, alcohols and formalin. So we are learning here third category, that is iodine. So iodine itself is a broad spectrum germicidal germicidal agent having antibacterial, antifungal and antiviral properties. So this is unique feature of iodine, that it is also having antiviral properties, antifungal, antiviral. So it is a very good disinfectant, we can say. It acts by oxidizing microbial protoplasm and precipitates proteins. So that is general actions. We have seen that how disinfectants acts over skin and other things for disinfection. Iodine is cheap, readily available and quick. So these are some features. It is cheap in rate, readily available and quick. Iodine is irritating to tissues, but the some drawbacks that it is irritating, particularly for the wound margins. Iodine is irritating. Iodine often causes sensitivity reactions and stains the skin. So iodine has a brown color, and when we apply it over skin, the skin is stained brown with iodine. So iodine is used in various forms, like tincture iodine, which is a 2% solution in 70% alcohol, polyvidone iodine PVI, that is betadine, as antiseptic for cuts and wounds. So betadine is a famous antiseptic which is used in hospitals and general clinics also for wound dressings. Iodine paint as antiseptic before giving injections. We all know that iodine paint is performed before giving injections or before starting any surgical procedure, iodine paint is applied. Iodine solution applied over skin for preoperative antisepsis. Yes, preoperative antisepsis, iodine solution is used. So Mendel's paint, which contains iodine as its active ingredient, it is applied on sore throat for germicidal action. So directly it is can also be applied over over throat for sore throat. Drop of tincture iodine added to a liter of drinking water for disinfection during emergency situations. So with chlorine, we have seen for water disinfection procedures or water sterilization procedures, we have seen that iodine is also used for disinfection purpose. Then the next comes hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide is an oxidizing liquid, acts by releasing nascent oxygen. Hydrogen peroxide, you all have seen that it contains nascent oxygen and it forms bubbles and soapy feel froth over whenever it is applied over a wound. So solution of hydrogen peroxide has poor penetrability and feeble germicidal action. So the motive of using hydrogen peroxide is cleaning rather than disinfecting the wound. So cleaning purpose is achieved through its nascent oxygen. It is commonly used for cleaning and the suppurative wounds and ulcers. The suppurative wounds are better cleaned with hydrogen peroxide. By releasing gas, it removes pus, slough and loosened dead necrotic matter, which is removed with the use of hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide is also used for gargling the mouth. It is used as a spray disinfectant for plastic goods and mechanical equipment. So these are general uses of hydrogen peroxide. It can also be asked for 2 marks question. Then alcohol and that is a spirit, the methyl alcohol. Disinfectant alcohols are ethyl alcohol and isopropyl alcohol. Between 60-80% concentration. They act as a disinfectants, and below that, at 50% level, they act as a bacteriostatic agents. Pure alcohol has no power of disinfections. So it should be remembered that pure alcohol has no power of disinfection. Ethyl alcohol, which is a methylated spirit, is used as a skin antiseptic before giving parenteral injections and hand washing. But because of their volatile nature, the alcohol does not possess sustained disinfectant action. Moreover, because of its toxicity and irritant nature, these alcohols cannot be applied to mucous membranes. So whenever you apply or you have experienced that you have applied alcohol or this spirit over a mucous membrane, it has a very, very irritating property. So it irritates to the skin, that's why it is not used. Because of its cost and flammability, its use is limited to certain article disinfections, as such as thermometer, hospital trolleys and tabletops in laboratories. Alcoholic solutions of chlorhexidine and iodine are effective antiseptics. That we have seen earlier that Cevolon with spirit is used as effective antiseptic. So their combinations are better used as antiseptic. Then comes formalin. Formalin, that is well known gas which is used for OT fumigation and also for the preservation of dead bodies in anatomy departments. Commercial formalin is 40% aqueous solution of formaldehyde gas and used as a spray for disinfections of room, tents, huts and vehicles. So just like operation theaters, formalin is also used for disinfection of rooms, tents, huts and vehicles also. It is also used for disinfection of delicate articles and jewelries. Used as preservatives for tissue organs in anatomy and physiology museums, for sending the tissues for histopath lab. 3% steam strength is used to disinfect rooms in the form of spray. So whenever formalin is used in the form of spray, it is used in lower concentration, only 3% strength. And 40% aqueous solutions are used for the fumigation purpose, like OT. 10% strength used to disinfect excreta. And formalin, that you all have experienced that formalin is irritating to the eyes and nose, and it often causes dermatitis. So these are the liquid disinfectants we have seen today. And gaseous disinfectants includes formaldehyde, ethylene oxide, sulfur dioxide. These are the gaseous disinfectants. So formaldehyde, gas obtained either by boiling liquid formalin or by pouring formalin over potassium permanganate. So formaldehyde gas, which is obtained for the fumigation purpose, it is obtained by boiling liquid formalin or just pouring a formalin over potassium permanganate. It will crystal, it release formaldehyde gas. Placed in a deep pan or bucket, this gas is also released by spraying formalin. Formaldehyde gas is inflammable, irritating, colorless, and highly toxic gas. Formaldehyde possesses germicidal actions against viruses, fungi, bacterial spores, acid fast bacteria. That means it acts as a sterilizer. Sterilization purpose is achieved by formaldehyde gas by killing viruses and spores also with the bacteria. It scores over chlorine. It is a notable thing that formaldehyde has a better sterilization effect than chlorine in disinfecting hospital equipments and instruments, in that it does not bleach textile and damages metals. So chlorine, on other hand, it bleaches the textiles and metals. On other hand, formaldehyde, when used as a gas, it does not bleaches. Formaldehyde gas is commonly employed for disinfection of rooms, especially operation theaters. So formalin is used for releasing formaldehyde in operation theaters by boiling or by pouring a formalin over a potassium permanganate crystals. Formaldehyde also has insecticidal action against mosquitoes, fleas, and lice, which is an added advantage. So the list we have seen till now, no other disinfectant have insecticidal action against mosquitoes and fleas. So formaldehyde gas gives added advantage to us. Gas is also employed for disinfections of books, clothes, blanket, bed, which cannot be boiled. So the things which cannot be boiled or even other solid or dry heat also can't be applied to these articles like books, clothes. So their formaldehyde gas is useful for sterilization of them. Its flammability, toxicity, and carcinogenicity are the limitations of formaldehyde gas. So these are the only limitations. Otherwise, it is good disinfectant. Ethylene oxide also is an extremely toxic, inflammable, irritating, and explosive gas, lethal to all kinds of vegetative forms of pathogens and viruses. So ethylene oxide is also a gas which is having a sterilization property, but it has a toxic and inflammable properties. That's why it is not popularly used. It is explosive. It is mixed with 12% carbon dioxide, then it becomes explosive. It is used for disinfection of fabric, rubber, plastic, and synthetic materials. Also employed for disinfecting variety of hospital equipments, electronic equipments, anesthetic equipments, cardiac equipments. So ethylene oxide, you should know for MCQ purpose with regards to your MCQ competitive exams that for anesthetic cardiac equipments, and this gas is used, that is ethylene oxide gas is used for these instruments to sterile them. It is not preferred when others are available. So ethylene oxide is generally not preferred due to its toxic and flammable nature. Then comes sulfur dioxide. It is also an irritating and highly poisonous gas which is produced by burning sulfur. It is more effective as an insecticide and rodenticide. So the gaseous disinfectants are generally used as insecticide and rodenticides along with formaldehyde gas. Sulfur dioxide is also can be used as insecticides. So here all disinfectants are finished. We have finished solid, liquid, gaseous, natural and other disinfectants. So go through this PDF I will share with you, and just have a look and revise it. In the next video we will see the disinfection procedures for disinfecting feces, urine and hospital disinfections and all these things. So till then, have a good day.